Well, that was definitely not the movie I was expecting.
Mamacita, ¿dónde está Santa Claus? ¿Dónde está Santa Claus?
Hey there, everybody. This is 22 Tiger Dude here, and Justin Watches Movies and I are going to be reviewing El Camino Christmas. So El Camino Christmas stars Luke Grimes, Tim Allen, Jessica Alba, Vincent D'Onofrio, Dax Shepard, Kurtwood Smith. You got a big cast in this film. The film tells the story of this young man named Eric, who is on the search for his father that he has never met in his entire life. However, while he's on the search, for no reason, he ends up being barricaded in a liquor store. So with it being Christmas Eve, Eric, as well as some other people, are stuck inside this liquor store.
Before I review El Camino Christmas, my guest star, Justin Watches Movies, is going to be reviewing it. So Justin, take it away, buddy.
Hey everybody on 22 Tiger Dudes channel. This is Justin Watches Movies here. On my channel, I do ranking videos, movie reviews, Blu-ray hauls, Funko Pop hauls, many things like that. So if you guys kind of like that stuff, come over to my channel, subscribe so you don't miss any fun. Thank you, 22 Tiger Dude, for asking me to join you on your channel for the holidays to talk about El Camino Christmas, which is a new Netflix original film. And despite having the word Christmas actually in the title, this really didn't feel like a Christmas movie. I was actually kind of disappointed because I always like when there's a new movie around the holidays that is based around the holidays and Christmas and such, and it really just feels like a Christmas movie, and we didn't get that really this year with even the El Camino Christmas. I didn't really find it to be a very enjoyable film, even as a storyline or just a movie in general. I didn't really have fun with this movie. Now, this movie stars a lot of people like Tim Allen and Dax Shepard and Jessica Alba, amongst many other people. And some of the characters I feel really just aren't needed to be in the story. Like, they went out and got Jessica Alba because she's Jessica Alba and they want to sell this movie. She really did nothing to this movie at all. And Jessica Alba is a really great actress. I really enjoy her in all of her movies. And it's sad that, you know, she's doing some of these smaller films that really have nothing to do for her character. She's just there to hold a camera and then have a baby, and that's it. Now, this movie is trying to have some sympathy for the characters, and, you know, if the holidays are about getting together with people. They have this guy who is trying to find his dad and gets stopped by the police and then escapes from the police and then stops at a liquor store, and kind of they get into this confrontation, the police and this guy, why he's trying to find his dad. And so there's trying to have this storyline of, you know, being with your family for Christmas, and it's not all about presents and, you know, different, the commercial stuff. And I understand why they went with that, but even that storyline still wasn't engaging or compelling at all. None of the characters, I could care if they got shot or if they found their father or whatever. I really did not care for the outcome of these characters. This movie is classified as a comedy, and I did not find this movie to be funny at all. You do have some pretty good comedians in here, like Dax Shepard and Tim Allen as well, who was nice to see on screen, but nothing in here felt like it was a comedy. It felt more like a drama, and even the drama still wasn't very dramatic. It's just a very one-note film that wasn't very exciting, wasn't very funny. I didn't enjoy it too much of. It was a very short film, about 1 hour and 29 minutes. It was an easy watch. Didn't really require much to think about. So I'm gonna have to go ahead and give El Camino Christmas a C-. So thank you, 22 Tiger Dude, for allowing me to be on your channel, talk about El Camino Christmas. Hopefully next year we get a better Netflix original Christmas movie. Thank you, 22 Tiger Dude. It's always a great time when I'm on your channel, especially the Halloween time and the Christmas time. Those are the two big times that I'm on your channel. Make sure to come over to my channel, give me a like, subscribe to my channel, and hit that bell notification on my channel and 22 Tiger Dude's channel so you don't miss a thing. 22 Tiger Dude has it, and I've always had it, and that is the Hack of Power!
Thank you so much, Justin, for reviewing El Camino Christmas.
So I was actually looking forward to El Camino Christmas because, one, it's a Christmas movie, and I love me some good old Christmas movies, and this looked like it had a lot of potential to be just a really fun and really funny movie because the trailer marketed this to be a comedy film. And in my intro, when I said this was definitely not the movie I was expecting, it was definitely not the movie I was expecting because El Camino Christmas is not a comedy. The trailer for this film was very misleading. There's definitely moments of humor in this film. And I'd say most of the time when it did have that humor, it worked for sure. But this is more of a drama. And I can't believe this is categorized as a comedy because, yes, there are moments where it has comedy, but it's really a drama. And that's actually quite disappointing. And I have no problem with dramas or anything like that, but I gotta be honest, that was the thing that made me feel really disappointed with El Camino Christmas. And even as a drama film, it's not even that good. However, there are good things in this film. Jessica Alba, even though her character isn't really given anything, she plays a news reporter. You know, that's all she does. She just reports the news. But I will say I did like her. I did enjoy her. Dax Shepard, I actually did really like here. And it's kind of funny because similar to Chips, he does play a cop. So thankfully, he does have a better cop role, and he actually did have some funny moments because let's just say his character isn't exactly the brightest, and I think that's what did add to some of his humor. So he did have his moments of making me laugh. Kurtwood Smith, you know, Red Foreman from That 70s Show, is in this film, and that was really cool. I thought Kurtwood Smith was actually really good here. I actually do think he gives one of the best performances. I'll get to who I think gives the best performance, but Kurtwood Smith really is so good in this film, and I really enjoyed him, and he had a couple moments where I definitely laughed too. And now this is where I talk about the best performance, in my opinion, Tim Allen. He was great. Because I don't want to say too much regarding him, but he plays an alcoholic, and how he portrayed this alcoholic was honestly very impressive. And I feel like dramatically, Tim Allen was the most believable. And Tim Allen is one of my favorite actors, so to actually see one of my favorite actors of all time being in a movie again, it really did feel so good to see. The cinematography I didn't feel was all that bad either. I did actually think it was actually pretty good, especially once they're outside. I did feel when they were outside in particular is when the cinematography actually did look very good. I was very impressed with cinematography. I liked how it was shot. Sometimes I did like the direction. And there is one moment that did get me into the Christmas spirit. Now, with all the positives I did get out of the way, unfortunately, the negatives I do have with El Camino Christmas is that this movie is so boring. Like, really, really boring. When the movie started out, I was not very impressed. And as the movie keeps going on, I just wasn't getting any more impressed, to be honest. Granted, there are some entertaining moments that happen, but even for a movie that's short, wow, does it really drag. This movie's only, I think, an hour and 27, 29. It's definitely around there. The runtime is pretty short, yet it feels like a two-hour movie. I'm not gonna lie, this felt like a two-hour movie. And the storyline just really isn't all that compelling. Like, I should be caring about the fact that Eric is on the search for his father, someone that he has never met in his entire life. Like, I should be caring about this. And I never really cared about his search for his father. Where the storyline led, as far as that goes, you're going, what was really the point of that? What was the point of sitting through this entire movie? They really don't go anywhere when it comes to him looking for his father. Also, I have to say, as far as Luke Grimes goes, I thought he was just fine. He's not awful, but the problem is that he's just pretty wooden. Like, even when he attempts to get dramatic, I didn't really buy into it. And Vincent D'Onofrio, notice how I didn't really bring up Vincent D'Onofrio in my positives. That's because I gotta be honest, he really wasn't that good. I didn't like his character. He's a corrupt police officer. Yeah, his character was actually kind of annoying, to be honest. And like I said with Jessica Alba, even though I did really like her, I did feel she gave a pretty good performance. Her role as this news reporter, yeah, wasn't all that great, and they really did not give her a lot. And my God, could this film be any more obvious with the twist? They throw in a twist at the end of this film, and I already knew this twist was gonna happen. And when it happened, I'm like, wow, movie, wow, you could not be any more freaking obvious with that twist. You gotta be for real with that. And the last thing I have to say this movie really failed to achieve was really get me into the Christmas spirit. When you watch a Christmas movie, you want a Christmas movie to get you into the Christmas spirit, right? I'm already in the Christmas spirit as it is, but when it comes to El Camino Christmas, wow, does it not get me into the Christmas cheer at all. Besides for one moment that deals with singing a Christmas song, that's all I'm gonna say as far as that goes. That's the only time I got into some kind of Christmas spirit with this film, but all the other scenes, nope, they did not get me into the Christmas spirit at all. Overall, El Camino Christmas is a very disappointing film. I do think it's very mediocre. It's really forgettable. Not a bad movie. I didn't hate sitting through this movie, but I was very let down by this film. I was bored a lot of the times watching this film. And there are parts of this film that were funny, but like I said, it's more of a drama film. And even as a drama film, it doesn't work. I'm going to give El Camino Christmas 2 out of 4 stars. So you guys, in the comments down below, let me know if you did see El Camino Christmas, which is on Netflix, what did you think about the movie? And I want to thank Justin so much for coming here to review El Camino Christmas. He's a very cool dude, you guys. He has a great channel. Please check out his channel if you haven't. I will leave a link in the description down below. This is 22 Tiger Dude here, and don't forget that I will always have Tiger Power!
O Pancho, O Vixen, O Pedro, O Blitzen, Olé!
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 Olé! Mamacita!